Dear students, welcome to Miss Anna's lesson again. So today's lesson is all about review from the stories Dear Mr. Blueberry and Cool Ellie. Once again, our review is all about the story Dear Mr. Blueberry and the story Cool Ellie. For that, let's have a warm-up dance exercise. So I want you to stand up and follow the dance.
They say, oh my gosh, I see the way you shine. Take your hand, my dear, and place them both in mine. You know you stopped me dead while I was passing by. Now I beg to see you dance just one more time.
Yes, very good. This is called dancing. Now, once you do that, we can dance this together, okay? Now, for your homework, you are going to have a recording of your voice. You can do an audio video recording of the story Dear Mr. Blueberry. Now here is the example. Now you can choose your own story.
Welcome to BB Story Time. Do you want to read this book with me? Don't forget to click the subscribe button for more. Dear Mr. Blueberry, by Simon James.
You're going to record your voice according to this one.
Dear Mr. Blueberry, I love whales very much. And I think and I saw one in my pond today. Please send me some information on whales, as I think he might be hurt. Love, Emily. Dear Emily, here are some details about whales. I don't think you'll find it was a whale you saw, because whales don't live in ponds, but in salt water. Yours sincerely, your teacher, Mr. Blueberry. Dear Mr. Blueberry, I am now putting salt into the pond every day before breakfast. And last night, I saw my whale smile. I think he is feeling better. Do you think he might be lost? Love, Emily. Dear Emily, please don't put any more salt in the pond. I'm sure your parents won't be pleased. I'm afraid there can't be a whale in your pond. Because whales don't get lost. They always know where they are in the oceans. Yours sincerely, Mr. Blueberry. Dear Mr. Blueberry, tonight I am very happy because I saw my whale jump up and spurt lots of water. He looks blue. Does this mean he might be a blue whale? Love, Emily. P.S. What can I feed him with? Dear Emily, blue whales are blue, and they eat tiny shrimp-like creatures that live in the sea. However, I must tell you that a blue whale is much too big to live in your pond. Yours sincerely, Mr. Blueberry. P.S. Perhaps it is a blue goldfish? Dear Mr. Blueberry, last night I read your letter to my whale. Afterward, he let me stroke his head. It was very exciting. I secretly took him some crunched up cornflakes and breadcrumbs. This morning, I looked in the pond, and they were all gone. I think I shall call him Arthur. What do you think? Love, Emily. Dear Emily, I must point out to you quite forcibly now that in no way could a whale live in your pond. You may not know that whales are migratory, which means they travel great distances each day. I am sorry to disappoint you. Yours sincerely, Mr. Blueberry. Dear Mr. Blueberry, tonight I'm a little sad. Arthur has gone. I think your letter made sense to him, and he has decided to be migratory again. Love, Emily. Dear Emily, please don't be too sad. It really was impossible for a whale to live in your pond. Perhaps when you are older, you would like to sail the oceans, studying and protecting whales. Yours sincerely, Mr. Blueberry. Dear Mr. Blueberry, it's been the happiest day. I went to the beach, and you'll never guess, but I saw Arthur. I called to him, and he smiled. I knew it was Arthur because he let me stroke his head. I gave him some of my sandwich, and then we said goodbye. I shouted that I loved him very much, and I hope you don't mind. I said you loved him too. Love, Emily, and Arthur.
Now, this is an example of reading aloud of the story, Dear Mr. Blueberry.
I hope you all enjoyed the story.
Now, you can do a homework like this, and you can try to open the PowerPoint presentation of Ms. Zamira. Or if you need my help, you can send a message to me on my WeChat, and I'm going to send the copy of the story that you'll be needing. Now, let's review some of your homeworks. Now, for this vocabulary test, Dear Mr. Blueberry, you need to fill in the letter of the definition that fits each vocabulary word. So, number one, details. Number two, disappoint. Number three, forcibly. Number four, information. Number five, oceans. Number 6, stroke. Now, for you to be able to learn better about these vocabulary, you need to listen to me and follow after me, and you need to remember the meaning of the word. Better you can write these words in your notebook, and then you can you can read it and remember the meaning of each word. So from the story Dear Mr. Blueberry, details means very good. Letter E, small bits of information. How about the word disappoint? Exactly, it's letter F, to make someone sad because something didn't happen. Disappoint. Number 3, forcibly. Great, strongly, by force. Number 4, information. Facts about a person, place, or thing. Now, please don't be confused between these two words, information and details. Most of you are confused about the meaning of these two words. Information, it talks about facts about a person, place, or a thing, or an animal. But when we say details, these are just small bits of information, additional information from that person or to that place or thing or animal. Now, number 5, oceans. Of course, this means large areas of salt water. And number 6, stroke. This means to rub something gently. Next, number 7. Emily wanted Mr. Blueberry to send information on whales. Number 8, Mr. Blueberry sent some details about whales. Some of you got confused between these two words. Number 9, whales always know where they are in the oceans. Number 10, Arthur let Emily stroke his head. And number 11, Mr. Blueberry had to point out quite forcibly that a whale could not live in a pond. Why? Because whales are too big enough to live in a pond. Number 12, Mr. Blueberry was sorry to disappoint Emily. For those who got a perfect score, good job. You are great. But for those who didn't get the perfect score, you can try to review again your mistakes. Now let's go to number 2, homework. This is also a vocabulary homework wherein you need to fill in the blanks with the correct vocabulary word. And there is also a comprehension test after this. Now try to listen to my sentence and then make a guess. Give me your answer. The choices are details, information, disappoint, forcibly, oceans, stroke. Number 1. The farmer had to blank put the pig in its pen. What do you think is the answer? Great. It's forcibly. Number 2, the author added many blank to the story. Many blank to the story. Is it information? Do you think it's details? Fantastic! Details. Number 3, I hope I do not blank you. And the answer is disappoint. I hope I do not disappoint you. I hope that you don't disappoint me as well. I hope that you just don't listen to this video. But you need to understand. You need to listen. You need to remember. You need to focus. Don't just watch the video until it ends. Remember A good student doesn't just listen. He or she must also understand the lesson. Number four, many different fish live in the oceans. Number five, my cat likes it when you blank his back. Good. Stroke his back. Number six, I can find a lot of blank about birds in this book. Awesome. Information. Good job. You got all the correct answers. Now let's proceed to the comprehension questions. Dear Mr. Blueberry has many exchanging of letters between Emily and Mr. Blueberry. Remember, Emily is the student of Mr. Blueberry. Now, number eight, how do you know Emily lives in Nantucket, Massachusetts? This is the answer, because you can see it in the postmark of the letter. Number seven, who is Mr. Blueberry? Please, I'm going to remind you again. You need to answer the sentences. You need to answer the questions in complete sentences. Practice and practice and practice. Don't answer in a shortcut way. Like, for example, who is Mr. Blueberry? Most of you answered a teacher. Teacher. Is it correct? No. It's still incorrect. You need to answer the questions in complete sentence. So Mr. Blueberry is a teacher, or Mr. Blueberry is Emily's teacher. Number eight, what is the first thing that Emily does to help her whale? Now, if you will go back to the story, Emily puts salt in the pan. Now let's go to number 11. What is Mr. Blueberry's second reason Alistair cannot be a whale? Now, let's go back to the story, Mr. Blueberry. Do you think Emily is just imagining or has imagination about a whale that lives in her pond? Yes. There isn't actually a whale in the pond. Why? If you go back to the story, Mr. Blueberry, as Emily's teacher, told her in the letter that our story cannot be a whale because a blue whale is much too big to live in the pond. Right? Now, Emily is just having an imagination that there is really a whale in her pond. Now, this is somehow very funny to the kids like Emily. Number 12. How does Emily feel when Arthur jumps up and spurts water? Now, she even gave a name to that whale, and the name of the whale is Arthur. Now, how does Emily feel when Arthur jumps up and spurts water? Of course, if it's in real situation, if I will be looking at that particular situation, I will be feeling happy. Emily feels very happy when Arthur jumps up and spurts water. But in reality, this will happen in the oceans. And if it happens, that blue whale will just spurt big amount of water. Now, number 13. When does Arthur let Emily stroke his head? Arthur lets Emily stroke its head after Emily reads Mr. Blueberry's letter. Now, this is very important. Migratory. For Miss Anna, migratory. What do you mean by this word migratory? It was mentioned in the story. Now, Mr. Blueberry explains that migratory means whales travel great distances each day. So, whales do travel great distances each day from one place to another place. Of course, oceans is so vast, so big. Now, Mr. Blueberry knows a lot about whales. Do you think Mr. Blueberry is a science teacher or a doctor or a scientist? Now, you can have some guess about my questions, because based from the story, Mr. Blueberry is giving a lot of details and information to Emily about whales. Number 16. Emily thinks that Arthur left the pond because, yes, because of the letter of Mr. Blueberry, that she thinks Arthur decided to be migratory again. When Emily reads the story, when Emily reads the letter of Mr. Blueberry about the blue whales, she was thinking that Arthur left the pond about migratory topic. Number 17. How does Mr. Blueberry try to make Emily feel better about Arthur leaves after Arthur leaves? Now, in the story, Mr. Blueberry says to Emily that when she gets older, she would like to sail the ocean studying and protecting whales. And last, why is Emily sure that the whale at the beach is Arthur? Emily is sure that the whale at the beach is Arthur because he lets her stroke his head. Do you think it really happened? I'll give you the next homework. Cool Ellie. Now, in this story, Ellie made everyone feel happy about her drawings, about her cool drawings, because it's summer season, it is too hot to stay inside their houses, and then when she gets outside the house, she drew a lot of cool things like beach umbrella for Ira, a little lake, snow dots, icicles, a polar bear that will make her drawings like a real snow or winter season in that place. Now, because of that, Mrs. Fry, Mr. Boyle, her mother, the babies, and everyone is happy because of this. Now, here, you need to fill in the letter of the definition that fits each vocabulary word. Number one, follow Miss Anna. Admired, fast, haze, mimicked, notice, pale. Number one is letter C. Admired means noticed something and liked it. Fast means showed unhappiness and complained, just like the babies did. Haze means misty, smoky, or dusty air. Mimicked means copied or imitate. Notice means be aware of. Pale means light in color. Now, for the next test, Ali was so busy she didn't notice other people coming outside. The babies fussed in the hot air. Mr. Poy looked into the hot haze and complained. The babies mimicked Mr. Poy. Ellie drew a polar bear with pale yellow fur. Ellie's mother admired what Ali drew. Let's try to open my PowerPoint presentation and review all of these again for the mastery of the lessons. Now, here is the spelling review. Now, number one, what is the right spelling of the word wife? W-I-F-E. Wife. Number two, wives. W-I-V-E-S. Wives. Number three, live. L-E-A-F. Number four, leaves. L-E-A-V-E-S. Number five, elf. E-L-F. Number six, elves. E-L-V-E-S. Number seven, shelf. S-H-E-L-F. Number eight, shelves. S-H-E-L-V-E-S. Number nine, life. L-I-F-E. Number 10, lives. L-I-V-E-S. Now, could you please repeat the saying the words twice? Wife, wife, wives, wives, leaf, leaf, leaves, leaves, elf, elf, elves, elves, shelf, shelf, shelves, shelves, life, life, lives, lives. Number 11. The shoemaker saw six elves. Number 12. Because of so many books, the shelves broke. Number 13. How many lives does a cat have? Number 14. The farmer's wives fed the cat. Number 15. Fall means that the leaves will fall to the ground. Number 16. The little elf lost his new coat. Number 17. The wives of the workers fix dinner. Number 18. The life of an astronaut is exciting. Now, again, I want you to review my PowerPoint presentation. You can print the paper and review it once again. Next, Cool Alley Study Guide Comprehension Questions. Now, but the first four is the vocabulary words. We couldn't see the sun because of the haze. Number two, Jane admired the pretty red bike. Number three, the children mimicked the ducks when they said quack quack. Number four, we didn't notice that Tom had left the room. Number five, the baby fussed because he wanted to eat. Number six, Bob mixed white paint and red paint to make a pale pink. Number seven, Cool Alley is a real story. Now, Dear Mr. Blueberry is not a real story. It's a fiction story. But Cool Alley is a real story. Don't forget that. What does Alley like to do? Of course, Alley likes to draw. Why does Alley go outside? Alley likes to go outside because it is too hot to stay inside the house. Number 9. When Alley goes outdoors, what is everybody thinking about? Alley likes to go outside because it is too hot to stay inside the house, and everybody is thinking about the cool breeze. How does Mrs. Fry show that she likes Alley's drawing? When Alley drew a little leg around Mrs. Fry's chair, she kicked off her sandals and wiggled her toes in the pretend water. Now, this is very funny because when Alley drew a little leg around Mrs. Fry's chair, Mrs. Fry pretended that, oh, it's real. Oh my, and she saw it. And then she kicked off her sandals and wiggled her toes in the pretend water. That means to say, she doesn't want to let Alley feel hurt that she might not believe in that drawing, but she pretended that it's real. Now, number 12. What does Alley draw to keep Ira cool? Alley drew a beach umbrella over Ira's head. But this, you can just like Ali draws the beach umbrella over Iva's head. Number 13. What is the setting of the story? Actually, the story happens in the city or outdoor. Number 14. What does Mr. Boyle do after Ali draws the north wing? He pretends he is cold and chatters his teeth. Ali drew little snow dots and icicles too. That makes everyone feel very cold and pretension. They just only pretend. Number 16. No one notices the rain because everyone is busy enjoying the snow. Pinch, trump, and hiss are sounds that make rain. In this story, moan means a low, sad sound. Remember from the story? Oh my, oh my. It rained, and then Ali just said, oh my, oh my. She felt very sad because all of her drawings were washed away by the rain. So when you hear the word moaned, it means low, sad sound. She isn't happy. Well, this is the end of the lesson now. See you soon. Goodbye. Thank you.